it's that centre button there, and it should say connecting going live.
That one, yeah.
As late as possible.
Thank you.
It's a real pleasure and a real joy to welcome you to St Thomas's Church, Pendleton, Salford, to celebrate the Christian marriage of Michelle and Clive. Welcome to those few who are in church. Welcome to those many who are online and joining us at home via social media this morning. We are here in the presence of God. We get to worship God and to celebrate the gift of Christian marriage. I'm going to use the more formal words at the beginning of the order of service on page 3. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And also with you.
God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. We say together the opening prayer. God of wonder and of joy, grace comes from you, and you alone are the source of life and love. Without you, we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that non-excellent gift of love, that we may worship you never with thankful hearts, and serve you always with willing hearts, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We're going to listen now to our first hymn, In Christ Alone. Would the congregation please be seated?
This cornerstone.
presence of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we have come together to witness the marriage of Michelle and Clive, to pray for God's blessing on them, to share their joy, and to celebrate their love. Marriage is a gift of God in creation, through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that as man and woman grow together in love and trust, they shall be united with one another in heart, body, and mind, as Christ is united with his bride, the Church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship, and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God, and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ, with those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty, which all should uphold and honour. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Michelle and Clive are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. We pray with them that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly life together. But first, I require to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. Michelle and Clive, the vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Clive, will you take Michelle to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Michelle, will you take Clive to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
The congregation, please stand. You may respond to this question at home as well if you'd like to shout out, although I don't think we'll be able to hear you. But I'm going to ask us all now to show our support for Michelle and Clive. Will you, the families and friends of Michelle and Clive, in church and at home, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will. Can
you make it a bit louder so they can hear it nice, loud and clear at home? Will you, the families and friends of Michelle and Clive, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
Thank you. We remain standing for this prayer. Let us pray. God, our Father, from the beginning, you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings upon Michelle and Clive, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated for our readings.
Love is kind.
Love is not envious, boastful, or arrogant, or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends, but as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes to the part, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror, dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of these, is love.
I always think you have to get the right accessory for a wedding outfit.
I'm worried.
You're worried? You asked me to do this, Clive. Or maybe it's Michelle, I don't know. So, we're here. I couldn't help thinking, but during that first hymn with those lines, no power of hell and no scheme of man, I was just thinking that the journey that you two have gone on to get to this point where you can get married, I think those words actually, no power of hell and no scheme of man, eventually stopped this happening. So it's great. I'm sure all of us are so pleased to be able to be here.
Amen.
I've got a question for you. Do they still teach you or try to teach you Greek when you train for ministry?
Yes.
They do? Yes. So, I don't know about you, but when I went to college, which was quite a few years ago now, they presented me with one of these. Have you got one of these? No, you haven't. Okay. So I got presented. This is a New Testament in Greek. Okay. And it says in the front here, it says, presented to David Hartman by the Bible Society, which the society is an interchurch agency seeking to glorify God to enable people around the world to own, use, value, and share the Bible in a language they understand. At which point we've put a question mark and said at the bottom after my year trying to do Greek, it failed. But I was in fact asked to leave my Greek class after 6 weeks. And the tutor said to me, David, you're confusing yourself and others. But one thing I do know about Greek is that that reading that we have from 1 Corinthians 13 uses the word agape, as the word for love. And I also know that in Greek there are different words for love. And that passage talks about agape, but the love that's brought you here, brought you to this point, is very much the eros, the romantic love. The love that sweeps you off your feet. The love that makes you miss somebody the moment they walk out the door. The love that makes you just smile when you think of that person. You're not looking too confused. That's good. That's good. You understand that love. So yeah, so that's the love that's brought you here. It's the love that we see and hear, we hear it in love songs. We see, we read it in those trashy romantic novels that some people might read. And we see it in those Hollywood movies that end with two people coming together despite everything that's happened and walking off into the sunset hand in hand. And it's a great love. It's a great kind of love. But you need more than that. I'm a bit of a grump when it comes to movies and it's a happy ending. I do not like happy endings in movies because it stops at that point and the whole of life is going to go on. And so that eros love, that romantic love that has brought you together is great, but you need something underneath it. And that's what Paul is talking about when he talks about the agape love that is patient and kind, that bears all things, that hopes all things, that believes all things. Agape, a love not just for a couple, but for everyone. Okay, another question. Do you know what the fourth selling album in 1982 was in this country? Anyone got any ideas? 1982, the fourth best selling album.
Depeche Mode.
No, not Depeche Mode. Good guess. It was ABC. Yeah? The Lexus, did someone get that? Wow. Have you ever been on a podcast? Because you should be. Yeah. ABC debut album called The Lexicon of Love. Now of course lexicon means a group of words. A lexicon is a group of words in a language about a subject. I actually think what Paul does in this passage from 1 Corinthians is create the lexicon of what love is. The words that describe what love is. Poets, songwriters, film writers, authors have been trying for years. But Paul sums it up in those words. He creates the lexicon of love. And so, this is a little wedding present for you. I don't know if you're ABC fans. Used to be, yeah. Well, if you want to play the record, you're going to have to take it out of there. But the disc is in there. That's just a reminder that the lexicon of love is the words that we hear in 1 Corinthians 13. Words, and I'm reading from the English translation because I can't read the Greek. But love is patient, love is kind, love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It's not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. But I've given you a reminder, because actually, there's one bit of advice that we didn't hear from Paul. And that's because when we divided up the Bible and put it into chapters, we naturally now just think of a chapter being self-contained. But if you read the first two words of chapter 14, Paul says, pursue love. Pursue love. And I think Paul knows full well that actually most of us, yeah, when we're the best that we can be ourselves, we are patient and kind. But when sometimes we're a bit more truthful to ourselves, we get irritable, we get resentful, we get arrogant. And so Paul says, pursue love, pursue this lexicon of love, pursue this agape. And that's why the eros love that is that wonderful moments that you have and will still continue to have, but when they're not there, sometimes you will have to pursue this love. And you have to work at not being irritable or arrogant or rude or resentful. And it's not because I know these two are saying this, because we are all like this, aren't we? We all know it. And so we pursue love. And when we pursue it, and when we are patient and kind, and not envious or boastful or arrogant or irritable, then people will see that love. Biggest single of that album? A Look of Love. Yeah, exactly. Yes, that was the easy question. So the biggest single of that album was The Look of Love. Don't read the lyrics. It's not quite what you think. But The Look of Love, I've got something else for you as well. This is the look of love. This is the look of agape. Because agape means a self-giving love. When we pursue that love, and when we're not irritable or resentful or arrogant, we are actually self-giving. And this, of course, is the ultimate sign of self-giving love. Now, I'm fairly confident that in your vicarage there's one or two of these, yeah? And they will remind you of your calling to be ministers to God's church. Some of them may also remind you of your calling to be missionaries into this world. But I give you this as part of your calling to be together. Your calling to pursue love. Your calling to be self-giving to each other. Even when you've given everything to the church, you've given everything to the world, and you get home and all you want to do is be pampered. Pursue love. Remember that Michelle or Clive, whichever way around it is, has probably had exactly the same day. And so remember this as a symbol of your commitment to agape, your commitment to self-giving love, your commitment to pursue everything that Paul says here. It's the look of love that can be reflected in your lives today. May God bless you. May God continue to enrich you, and may God help you to pursue agape love in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Save them now. Thou my best.
Michelle and Clive, I now invite you to join hands and make your vows in the presence of God and his people. Clive, please, could you repeat after me? I, Clive, take you, Michelle.
I, Clive, take you, Michelle.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
Please repeat after me. I, Michelle, take you, Clive.
I, Michelle, take you, Clive.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death we do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
We'd like to do a stand to the front. Do we have the rings? First, we ask God to bless the rings. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Michelle and Clive a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Michelle, I give you this ring.
Michelle, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share.
All that I have, I share.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Keep holding his hand. Please repeat after me. Clive, I give you this ring.
Clive, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
In the presence of God and before this congregation, Michelle and Clive have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are now husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love and peace and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessing upon Michelle and Clive, in their life together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, awake and asleep, in life and in death, in joy and in sorrow. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace. You may please him both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Do you like to stand? Michelle, you may now kiss the groom. Can we give them a round of applause, please?
Responses for each of the prayers. So when we finish each section with Lord of life and love, please respond with hear our prayer. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
Faithful God, holy and eternal, source of life and spring of life, we thank and praise you for bringing Clive and Michelle to this day. And we pray for them. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
Loving Lord, we claim the words of Ecclesiastes from the Shell and Clive. A cord of three is not easily broken. We pray for you, Lord God, to be interwoven in all areas of their married life. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
May you protect them, their home, their families, and for them to know you, your peace in the heart of their marriage. We pray that day after day after day, they may turn to you, a source of life and love beyond themselves, where they may forgive each other quickly, let go of fault and shame. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
May Clive and Michelle know your joy and grace as their mutual ministries flourish. Greater than the sum of two parts, that you may anoint them. May their service to you and each other, may you grant them rest and sight. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
May their marriage be life-long, enriched by your presence and strengthened by your grace. May they bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
May the hospitality of their home bring refreshment and joy to all around. May their love overflow to neighbours in need and embrace those in distress. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
May they discern in your word order and purpose for their lives, and may the power of the Holy Spirit lead them in truth and defend them in adversity. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
In your spirit, deep and still,
our prayer.
We conclude our prayers together as our faith Saviour taught us, so we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Thank you, Laura and Matthew, for the prayers. We continue to enjoy music now and singing as we come to the signing of the registers. I'm going to invite the bride and groom to come up and sign the registers first of all, and then the witnesses afterwards.
Thank you. So
Well, we've all waited a long time for this day. Not only Michelle and Clive, but all of us. Our church community is here, across Salford, and family and friends of Michelle and Clive. It hasn't been the wedding that they were planning, but it's been a wonderful, wonderful occasion. A real privilege and a real honour to share in it and to witness it as you have celebrated your marriage together. And I know I speak for everybody here and everybody at home when we wish you every blessing and every happiness in the future. Thank you to all of you who have shared in this service, the readings, the prayers, Dave for that wonderful message, and Chris for the music. Thank you all so much. Would you please stand as we now ask for God's blessing. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
You won't be able to hear it at home, but the bells are actually ringing as well. If you can just see up in the tower. No, you can't see, I'm afraid, but the ringers are working hard and they're ringing bells for Michelle and Clive as they leave church today.
Thank you.
springs from the valleys, they flow between mountains. Birds of the air dwell by the waters, lifting their voices in song, singing
to be with us, folks. I'm about to sign off. The sun is shining, the bells are ringing, so the ending of the service has been absolutely lovely as well. Hope that you might be with us tomorrow morning when we'll be broadcasting, streaming live from here at 10 o'clock for our morning service. Enjoy the rest of the day and the rest of the weekend. God bless. Bye.